I was pretty much letting her know that there is nothing in the future that's gonna make us rekindle our friendship because she wouldn't have my back and pretty much backstabbed me. I go back in the room to see if LaTasha has come back home because LaTasha doesn't like going through the front door. She loves going through the back door where our room's at. And LaTasha's still not there. I asked BJ and Monet if they've seen her. Of course, they're just sitting there being bitchy and I'm like, okay, you know what? I don't got time for this. I'm not about to like socialize with you. I'm gonna try and be a bitch and get attention for TV.
Oh, look who came in.
I don't want any trouble right now. I'm actually feeling really pretty. So, I don't want to like... Well, it's not going to do anything to me because I'm always going to look good, but... Mm-hmm. Where's LaTasha? Did she leave? And not that I care, but where's Kathy? She's also gone too.
I think Kathy went to breakfast and I have no idea where LaTasha is.
You have no idea where she went?
Monet, do you know? Monet doesn't know either. Really? Mm-hmm.
I can see
both
cars are gone.
Gia comes out and she's like, hey, where's LaTasha? And I just say, like, I don't know, because like I really just don't want to deal with her.
So where do you think LaTasha is?
I know where LaTasha is.
Yeah.
She's in the hotel. Because we kicked her out.
Oh, she don't. I mean, I know that's my sister and all, but like, I'm just tired of arguing and fighting with her. I just want to talk and like, you know.
I agree, but she won't talk at all. She'll just like throw
she
you
just
to the ground.
Hitting, I know, but like, at least it's gonna be like calm and like no fighting today. Like, oh, I'm tired. I'm getting sick, and I don't feel like it.
You know what we should do is just kind of talk to Gia and see if we can get her to just like kind of calm down with the drama also.
Mm-hmm. Even though I don't like her.
I know, I don't think anyone does. I was just thinking if I could get on Gia's good side, then maybe she could join my alliance and, you know, be like the biggest, baddest bitch of the house and stuff, right? Because that would be, of course, me.
Oh, car's gone, so I don't know where she is.
Gia, can I talk to you?
About what? Did you actually want to talk, or you can try to throw that wine in my face?
No, I'm not going to put a wine in your face. Here, I'll get you a glass, and let's go outside, and
have the girls in the house are fucking crazy, and all they're doing here is just wanting attention. What her and BJ did was pretty much like a F you to my face, because, like, they didn't listen and they didn't care, so it really pissed me off about that.
Okay, so...
It's one outside.
I think that I agree with you with the whole no drama type thing, and I think that to live in this house together and to get the money at the end of the show, I think that we should just make it easy for each other and just, you know, like get along. And I know that that's going to be really difficult for LaTasha, and especially for Kathy, because she's really not happy with you since like you like I don't know like broke up their friendship I guess.
I don't know what she told you and I really don't care, but I understand where you're coming from now, but the conversation we're having right now was what I was trying to get at like yesterday, and then you guys all turned around and pretty much said a F you to my face and ganged up on LaTasha, so that's why I'm a little bit upset at you guys.
Yeah, and, like, I can understand that you're upset, but I mean, I'm sorry about that, and I know that Kathy probably isn't because she's talked a lot of shit about you.
I don't give a fuck about Kathy.
Well, she's just...
There's a flag. Of course, BJ's sitting there, and she's talking and giving me the same conversation that I gave her yesterday, saying that she didn't want drama in the house and that she was over it, and that we're at a nice, beautiful house. We shouldn't be fighting. And I'm just rolling my eyes like, bitch, did I not just say this yesterday? Like, we could have done this yesterday, but you and your little friends decided to jump on my girl.
She says that you're trying to take Arnold away from her. And
okay, listen. I do not give a fuck, a flying fuck, about Arnold. I really don't. Do I think he's cute? No. Do I think he's ugly? No. But I don't think he's attractive. Like, he's not my type. Like, I have my own man.
Right, that's what I thought. And so that's why I was trying to, like,
so, like, happy. You know, I have a very successful job. I have a grown man. I have a nice apartment that I live at that I absolutely love. I have really good close friends. And you know what? Kathy was in that circle, but now she's out of it because she's trying to, like, blame and accuse that I'm jealous of her man. Mm-hmm. Like, why should I worry about your man when I got my own life? Like, I'm not in high school. And I'm not jealous. I don't get jealous. I'm never jealous. Like, people are jealous of me.
Yeah, I think that Kathy's absolutely overreacting. I think it's just because of your talk with her, and she's just really upset and wants to get back at you. So I'm a little bit worried that, you know, she's, like, gonna snake behind your back and do something. I mean, like, she's already done.
Okay, what do you mean? What do you mean that she's done?
Well, I mean, like, she's really, really, like, spreading rumors, like...
Typical Kathy.
Yeah.
I know that she's been spreading rumors, and that's fine. She can spread them because people aren't obviously going to believe them. Like, she tried selling a story to TMZ about how, like, I tried having sex at, like, a bar on top of the bar or whatever. I don't know. It's really stupid. I kind of laughed.
Oh, that's some Miley Cyrus shit.
Yeah, I laughed. It was like she tried selling that story to them. Are you fucking kidding me? They obviously didn't believe her. And
it's not like she had any paparazzi.
And do you see how she dressed? She obviously didn't get that money. Mm-hmm. Or how she looked. She still needs that facelift.
That Kathy was talking a lot of shit about her, and that I think that she should know that since, like, we're trying to be friends a bit and stuff, and I know that their relationship is completely broken up.
I just want to know, like, were you or Monet or Kathy, like, whose idea was it to lock me and LaTasha out?
Like, it was absolutely Kathy, 100%.
Did she write all those mean, nasty mm-hmm. things?
She was like, oh, we should do this. And I just, you know, I kind of, like, went along with it just because,
I can tell,
like,
you were a little bit tipsy, so I'm guessing she, like, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, when I get tipsy, I just, like, kind of go along with things. So I didn't exactly know what was going on. Like, you know, the whole phone call thing. Like,
I understand about that. That's why I talked to you about it. I'm like, you know what? It's not your fault. I understand. And that's why I got mad because, you know, we talked about it, and then you didn't listen, and you, Kathy and Monet? Yeah, you, Kathy and Monet, like, all ganged up on LaTasha, and it just really pissed me off. It's like, we don't need that drama. Mm-hmm. Like, look at this house, look at this view, we're sipping here, dripping our port wine, and, like, you know, we're supposed to be living it up. We don't need to be yelling at each other, we don't need to be, like,
I agree.
Calling each other ugly or fat or anything like that. And she started telling me all the stuff about Kathy and what Kathy has said, and it doesn't surprise me. Kathy's, like I said, Kathy's really thirsty for money and for fame.
Did I tell you what she said last Saturday?
What did she say?
She said that you went out and you were, like, in the bathroom, like, doing lines of coke. That's what she told me.
Really? That's what she told you?
Uh-huh.
Trying to probably sell fucking storage to see again. I'm over it. I'm done. Cheers to new beginnings. Like, I'm done with this. Like,
I agree.
It's going inside. It's getting gray and cloudy. For Kathy to say all the stuff, I'm not surprised. It's just her just pretty much BJ detailing what Kathy's been doing and saying to me. And it's annoying a little bit, but it's whatever. I'm not going to take it personally because Kathy doesn't know me that well anymore. She's not my best friend, so.
When I came back, BJ came up to me and was like, oh, can I talk to you for a minute? I was like, okay. Hi.
Hi, Kathy. The freaking place is cold. So, I had a long conversation with Gia.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to let you know what she said.
What she
said? She said that, that you were jealous of her and that she was completely above you. And I just want to let you know that, like, she's a two-faced bitch. And I think that you should confront her when you're ready to.
Okay, but why would she say something like that?
I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of rumors going around like that. And
what kind of rumors?
Just like rumors that like you've like got it out for her and stuff like that.
What?
I think it's LaTasha feeding her lies.
Gia's been talking a lot of shit. She's been saying this and spreading all these rumors and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, what? Why would Gia do that and stuff? And she's like, yeah, she said you're like here and she's like here. Like, I'm like, what the fuck? Why would Gia say that?
So, the class is gonna be here and we're about to go to a club. If y'all are going, you should ask Kenji to come if she wants to go.
Okay.
She doesn't deserve to go.
Yeah, I don't think Gia should go either. I don't need any more shit tonight.
Yeah. I don't want Gia to come. And BJ's like, yeah, we should invite her. And I'm like, no, I don't want her to go. And because I don't want drama and trouble to go on.
I knew that Gia and Kathy were fighting and stuff. So I decided, you know, like maybe they'll fight. I don't know. But we'll see what happens.
And my heart beats in stereo.
LaTasha's sister wanted to start shit with me, and she wanted to fight me for some reason. I don't know why she wanted to fight me.
I'm gonna get her. Mm-hmm. That girl, Gia, what the fuck her name is.
Bitch, you're not hard. Like, calm the fuck down. You know?
Hands
back off. Yeah, like, you know those girls? Remember that one girl that tried, like, trying to like, get in a fight with you because she was trying to act all hard? And then, like, you threw your drink in her face, and she cried?
Yeah, her.
Yes, she reminds me of that girl. Like, she tries to act really, like, ghetto, but I can see right through it that she's actually, like, an Oreo. She tries to act ghetto. She's like an Oreo. She's white on the inside. Like, you know, I heard one of her phone calls, and she did not sound ghetto at all. She sounded like a valley girl. I'm gonna go back home so bad. I'm just...
Do it.
I know, I'm just over it. Like, everyone here is annoying. Kathy's trying to start a shit with me for no reason. I don't know why. She thinks I'm jealous of her man. You know the one I'm talking about, the really short one?
Ew, Matt, why would you get jealous of that?
I don't know, what was his name? Like, Arthur or Arnold or something?
I have no idea, it was like a cartoon character name.
The girls in the house are fucking crazy and all they're doing here is just wanting attention. The girls are hungry and thirsty for fame on the show.
To confront her, so I come back to the house and I confront her.
Gia, where are you? Fuck!
Stop!
I don't want to be in this house. Fighting all the damn time.
Could you please like get Gia out of the house because she is causing so much shit right now.
I just want us to be friends again. That's all.
How are we going to be friends when you're accusing me of sleeping with your man?
Well, I don't think you should go though.
What is there here for me? I don't even